Coming up, we'll take a look at new classroom experiences with Office 365, including how you can bring everything in one place to drive collaboration, including your files, conversations, and assignments, and use familiar Office apps, including OneNote and now even Sway. And if you're in IT, we'll show you how you can light up these new experiences for your school. I'm joined today by Ari Shore from the education team. Welcome.
Great to be here.
So Ari, we've done a lot of work with Office 365 and education, but what's behind all that work?
Yeah. So we're really trying to bring custom productivity solutions to the classroom for teachers and students, and building off some of the familiar learning tools that we have with Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and OneNote, but also bringing in new learning tools like Sway to really give like a great collaboration experience within the classroom.
So can we take a look?
Yeah, sure. So taking a look at the Office 365 new Microsoft Classroom experience, you can see it's really built on Office 365 groups where you have the classes along the left-hand side, So Art, Biology 8A. And then there's another type of group that I want to first show you, which is the PLC group, or Professional Learning Community group. And that's really where teachers can collaborate together.
So it's kind of like the teacher's lounge or something then, right?
Exactly. So if we jump into the PLC group, very similar to what you saw with Office 365 groups, but it's got relevant content for educators. Mm-hmm. So with the new connectors within Office 365 groups, you would be able to bring in things like Twitter feeds, like hashtag EdTech, a conversation that's happening outside of the school boundary.
Right.
And then you have relevant materials like a notebook, so a OneNote notebook that has things like SMART goals or meeting minutes from that meeting with your co-teacher. And then it also has things built in like the new Office 365 Planner. And so if you go into Planner, what's great is you can track the status of tasks as well as, you know, if you look at a board, you can add relevant categories of tasks. So if I go over here to like buckets, I can see like I have to grade homework 2, decide on roles, I can check that off. And so that's great to have a place to manage all of my tasks within that PLC environment.
And this is really a good use case for Planner, especially because when you think about a teaching environment, you want to have a teacher, a couple of teacher's assistants. They're in Planner, basically able to assign tasks, manage those projects, whether it's a science fair, a field trip, the classroom itself, really great experiences. But beyond what we're seeing here from that teacher's lounge perspective, what does the classroom experience look like?
Yeah, the classroom experience is, again, just a slight tweak on that. So if you jump back into Classroom, you can see that we have our Office 365 groups. We've pinned some favorites, like Biology 8A, and I can just jump right into that. And when I jump in, the thing that I see is the thing that's most relevant to teachers and students, which is assignments. And so in the assignments, obviously, I have the list. I can see how many have been turned in, how many have been graded. But what I want to do is show you the instructional piece of it. So how do these assignments get populated in here? I could just add an assignment from here, but most of the time, from what we've seen with the momentum in education, the teachers and students are spending time in the class notebook.
Okay.
So if I jump over to the class notebook, I can just launch that within OneNote. And what you see is this custom-built environment for teachers and students to work together. And that has areas for collaboration. So teachers and students have full access to that. And then there's a content library, which is where handouts, class notes, assignments can all be held, kind of like a digital filing cabinet, and then distributed to students to complete.
Okay.
And that's where students get their personal notebooks to then complete those assignments.
Right.
So if we jump into the content library for a second, you can see we have different homework assignments as pages within OneNote. We have this biology homework 3 that we'd like to distribute to all the students. And so if we do that, we just go within the new class notebook add-in, which is built into OneNote, and say create assignment. And when we do that, we can just grab the description that's already populated in there off of the content on the page. Maybe we want to give it a little bit more color and say label that plant cell structure. We can create it in all the assignment sections of those students' notebooks.
Okay.
We can assign a due date. So say we want to make it due not on a Saturday, probably on a Monday, you would hope.
Right.
And then just sit create. It will actually send the assignment using an assignment service out to Microsoft Classroom.
Very cool.
If we jump back into the browser, we can actually see that new assignment, homework 3, show up in here. And you see that if you scroll down right there. So it's important to note that even though I've already distributed the assignment to Microsoft Classroom, mm-hmm. a teacher or student may have a separate learning management system already in place.
Okay.
And so what's great is I can actually connect to those learning management systems via an assignment service, like I just showed you, via this dropdown here too. So I can see, you know, other learning management systems like Blackboard, Canvas, Edmodo, and we can push that same assignment to those. And so if I go into the browser, I can just jump over to Biology Homework 3 within Canvas, another okay. learning management system. So it really fits the needs of whatever the teachers are already using in their classroom.
Right, very flexible.
And so now, the next thing that the teacher wants to do is review the student work. And so to do that, she actually has a button within the OneNote class notebook add-in mm-hmm. to just pull up all of the assignments within those students' notebooks.
Okay.
So if I hit the review student work thing, it pops up a pane. I can look at that assignment that I just distributed, Biology Homework 3. Mm-hmm. I can sort by last name of the students, and I can enter grades. So now that we have the grades connected from Microsoft Classroom, we can actually just jump into any of the students' personal notebooks. So in this case, we want to look at William Hunt, the student. Mm-hmm. We can just click on his notebook here. So I could, you know, pinch to zoom using OneNote's touch capabilities, scroll down, see if he's labeled this plant cell structure correctly. I could even look at some of his supplementary materials. He's got an embedded PowerPoint on there that I could open up if I wanted to. And then I can just ink the grades on there, which inking is one of the big benefits of OneNote. So I can ink 9 out of 10, give him his grade in line here, hit submit, and send that off to the assignment service, shows up in Microsoft Classroom or whatever learning management system we have in our school.
Now I'm really excited about that because of two things. I'm going to switch roles and I'm going to be William Hunt because I'm a student in your class. I just want to show you what the experience looks like for me then using OneNote in this experience. So now I've got OneNote open. And here you can see I've only got the things that I'm allowed to see as William Hunt. So if I click into my own notes, I see here I've got my handouts. You saw the photosynthesis thing earlier. All of my assignments, and there's that biology homework that you assigned to me just now. Also my genetics homework and my class notes, everything I've taken in terms of notes through your classes. And I go back to my handout here, and there's another cool tool I want to point out that I can use as William, the learning tools. Now what that allows me to do is actually launch into an immersive reader, and that will actually read back the assignment to me using Narrator inside of Windows.
Take photosynthesis quiz.
And I can also see some really great views in terms of reading comprehension to make that better. One last thing I want to show you is I can also take a quiz. In this case, we're using Office Forms. It's really cool. It's going to open up that Office Form, give me all these different, in this case, radio buttons and things that I can then use to actually fill in that quiz. And once I submit that to you, you can actually see that and grade it in the same way that we just saw.
Real-time results.
With real-time results. So I can see how I did actually on that quiz. So very, really cool, very integrated stuff here. Now, another thing that we can do as students and another great tool that we have is Sway. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to open up Sway, and I've got a couple other students I'm working on this with. Here, I've got two authors in the doc right now. And really what Sway does is it allows me to import pictures, text into this really rich kind of multimedia layout here on the web. And that then does all the design work for me. So I don't have to worry about the WYSIWYG work of getting all the images and everything in the right spot. It gives me a great design, a great way to actually tell the story, in this case of endangered species. Puts all of the pictures in the right spots, the right size, the amount of emphasis. And all of that I can collaborate with my classmates on to really have an excellent experience and be able to use some of the newer tools even in Office to really help with my classroom and with the students I'm working with.
And what's actually really great about Sway is that we're going to be bringing that into the new classroom experience. We're actually working with the team to make sure that assignments like a Sway yep. can be integrated, submitted, and graded, very similar to what you saw with OneNote.
Very cool. But there's one other aspect I think we should talk about here, because as the teacher, typically you have to do a lot of things in terms of managing the students that are in your class and all of that work to get them all into one group.
Very manual.
That gets a bit different in this case, right?
Exactly. Yeah, we actually have a new service called School Data Sync mm-hmm. that will allow you to populate all of those student names and rosters into Office 365 groups.
So it's really easy in terms of School Data Sync. And if you think about it from an educator perspective, you've got a couple of things that you're typically using in order to manage your students, your teachers, all the different what we call objects in directory services worlds in your classroom. So in our case, we're going to take our student information system, all the teachers, the teacher rosters, the school information, that's the students, et cetera, move that through our school data, or our school data sync, the SDS here, and that's going to basically populate everything into Office 365. So we have Azure Active Directory then backing up, putting everybody into groups and doing all the stuff that we just saw here, the classrooms all organized. But I'll show you what that looks like, because it's really quite easy to get all that running. So here I've got the SDS open. If you go to the link below, you can actually see how to access that. And I've created a profile called School for Mechanics. Now, first thing I have to do is actually take an output of all my SIS information as CSV files. And here I've got about a half a dozen CSV files for school sections or the classes, the students, student enrollment, teacher, teacher roster. And here is just a section. This is like a class with the IDs, the names of the classes, all of the start and stop dates of the classes. So all of that's ready to go. Once I select all those things and hit open, that's basically going to start giving me the ability to upload that into our SDS. After that's done, I've got now the files archived in the SDS, I can start the sync. And what the sync's going to do is actually take all of that data, merge it together, and then give me effectively a data structure that has all my classes, my students, my teachers, everything in this view that you saw, to where it's all organized for me.
That really saves teachers a ton of time, doesn't it?
Right, so that's going to save you a ton of time. So when that's all done and ready to go, I'm just going to click into my View Teacher, Students, and Sections tab, and now I can see all my courses, math, science, English. I can click into my teachers, and I can see all the teachers that are put in. This is a smaller school. There's only three teachers, and there's about half a dozen students in our school, but we have all the students already enrolled, so very quick, very easy to get everybody in my classroom.
That's amazing, and it can sync every night if you wanted to, so even when there are changes in enrollment for a particular class, that all shows up in my classroom experience.
It's really great to see all of these things come together. Of course, you can try all of this at the link below if you want to try out the classroom experiences, and also if you're in the IT department, check out the link below to try out School Data Sync for yourselves. Of course, keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for all the latest updates. Thanks for watching, and goodbye for now.